Each one of the 1,000 bikini bottoms was made of cork. There were deliberately no tops, by the way, because the bottom parts on their own are not only supposed to be artistic, but non-sexist too. 174 of them were painted with the flags of all the world's nations, the rest having just different designs and images on them. The artist, a Czech-born Midlander called Bob Pollack, remained in the Midlands. After all, he said in a statement, his absence from the scene was no more incongruous than Moses not entering the Promised Land. Nonetheless, a colleague from Central Television tracked him down and asked him what he was trying to achieve.
Well, all the work is a development of my interest in two-dimensional art, paintings if you like. And it is an extension of that. Everyone deals with a form of two-dimensional communication. There is no sculpture, although people might see it as sculpture, it is not. There's no 3D in it. They will resemble something like leaves of water lilies on the water. And if people are familiar with, say, Monet's water lilies, I envisage a similar type image. The only difference, as far as people might see, is that they're not in a gallery or hanging on a wall. And the same principle, they're flat pieces of artwork floating on a lake. Slightly different, I agree, but innovative. The whole point of this is that something different, a progression, a development.
Aha. So I then asked Dean Chapman, a student of his who was doing the honours in Hyde Park, what he thought it was all about.
It's the social context of bathing in a public area and the relationship between actual bathing and the articles you wear while bathing. It's a lot to do with history and the way Eve put the fig leaf across herself, and it develops from there.
Mr. Pollack's next project is to see what pattern the tyres of motorists make when they drive over a piece of wet canvas at Junction 15 on the M1. That's sometime in the future, though. Meanwhile, today's artistic experience didn't last long. The bikini bottoms were removed from the water after 3 hours, a brief encounter, you might say, leaving the Serpentine Lido once more to its more usual swimmers. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.